Come morning, the old kettle felt a bump bump. It woke to discover itself at the dump. More peelings, more tin cans, a mattress, a bone. The old kettle had never felt so much alone. With nothing to sing for and no one to care, the kettle stood under a broken down chair.
It hunched there all autumn, all winter till spring, when in spite of its state, it felt it must sing. It sang for the sweet breeze, it sang for a bird who had just sung to it, and the rag picker heard. He heard old kettle and quick picked it out. He looked at the handle, he tapped on the spout. You're perfectly fine, you've got plenty of life. So he brought the old kettle back home to his wife. The ragpicker's wife, who admired such thrift, gave her husband a hug for his most welcome gift. She signed the old kettle, she said, good as new. And the kettle, now beaming, knew just what to do. It sang in the cottage when the sun shivered high. It sang over biscuits and gooseberry pies. It sang for the children, its voice filled the house. It sang for the cat and the brave kitchen mouse. It still sings. Voice, oh joy, and cheer, if you pass by the rag picker's cottage, you'll hear.